Hey folks, I might be old, I might be gray, and I might drive a desk for a living, but I know how to keep my feet warm. And when you do outdoor activities in cold climates, you get really good at making sure your feet stay warm. And that's what this whole video is about. And you're gonna see me using all this Kennetrek stuff, but this applies no matter what kind of boot, what brand, what style you use. So I'm gonna walk through this, and hopefully when I'm all done, you'll realize how you could keep your feet a lot warmer in cold weather, which means you're gonna stay out there longer, you're not gonna be distracted, and your likelihood of success is gonna go up. The very first thing you need to understand when we're talking about warm feet is it's really about moisture management. I'm talking about moisture from the outside of your boot and moisture from the inside of your boot. Moisture creates evaporation, which will amplify and accelerate heat loss from your skin, depending on who you talk to, anywhere from 5 to 8 times faster because of moisture and evaporation. So that's why keeping your feet warm is all about moisture management. So like I said, there's two parts, internal management, external management. I'm gonna talk about managing the internal moisture that comes to your boot, your socks, all your footwear via perspiration, because that's the one you can manage. The others you can almost prevent, but the internal one is more about management because you can't get rid of it, you just have to manage it. One of the things we wanna focus on is internal moisture management is all about managing the moisture from perspiration. And there's a couple ways that you can do that. And I'm gonna walk through a day of hunting. Okay, here's what my day is like in November in Montana. It's rifle elk season. I'm gonna get up in the morning, whether I'm gonna be driving to a trailhead or I'm messing around camp and then I leave from camp. Either way, these principles are the same. What you don't wanna do is get out of your sleeping bag and throw your hunting socks and your hunting boots on. If you're gonna be messing around camp, you're gonna start perspiring in your boot before you even start hunting. Or if you're gonna drive to the trailhead, don't put your hunting boot and your hunting sock on, because in the time it takes for you to drive that 20 miles to the trailhead, you've already started the process of your feet sweating. And that is going to introduce moisture into the equation. So what do? Well, have a pair of camp socks and camp shoes or camp boots. I don't care what they are. That's what you wear before you start hunting. I am starting the day with super dry feet, super dry socks, and super dry boots. So I'm already ahead of the game. So that's the very first step of how your day starts and how you can get off to a good start by not leaving the truck or leaving the trailhead or camp with boots and socks that are already damp. So now you start hiking up there. My normal morning is, all right, I got an hour, 2 hour hike, maybe in the dark. I get right up there, right at glassing light, perfect morning. And now I'm probably gonna be stationary for the next 2 to 3 hours. Well, guess what? I've probably introduced a lot of moisture to my boot because of perspiration. So a lot of times you'll see us, and I'll take my boot off and I'll just let that moisture start coming out of there. And if my feet are feeling like they're starting to get really cold, I always bring at least one pair of extra dry socks with me. And if I know I'm gonna be there all day, I'm putting these dry socks on. I'm not gonna stand up there and try to stay warm with wet socks that are full of perspiration. I'm not gonna win that battle. That's what you're doing while you're out in the field. You are managing how much moisture accumulates and how you get that moisture out during the day. Now let's talk about when you go back to camp. So when you get back to camp, the very first thing you do is you take your hunting boots off, you take these socks that are now damp from being out there hunting and hiking all day, and you pull your insoles out. And this is the little trick, no charge for this trick. You see this? Hand warmers. You open it up, you tilt this boot up like that, and you drop one in each boot. What happens is that hand warmer slides right down to the toe, and you get this full, warm, hot, dry air current coming up out of here. It will dry your boots out every time. Now you got damp socks. Okay, if you have a fire and a stove, make sure you dry out your socks every night. Sometimes you're cold camping and you can't really do that. So take your insoles, take your socks, Bring them in your sleeping bag with you and cook the moisture out of them. Your body temperature in your sleeping bag will be enough to dry these out. And if you had a second pair that was also damp because you're rotating, bring them in your sleeping bag with you. If you're cold camping, that is going to be the biggest problem you have, is keeping your feet warm. If you're in a wall tent or you've got a stove in your tent, yeah, you'll probably put your boots near there to dry it out. But if you're cold camping, this, and putting all of this inside your sleeping bag is going to get you ready for the next morning. So one of the important components of this whole system of moisture management is your sock selection. Make sure you select a sock, a high quality sock of either a wool or some sort of wool blend that is proper for the type of condition you're in. Now let's talk about external moisture management. How do you keep moisture from getting in your boot from the outside? Well, the very first thing is get a high quality pair of boots. I know you keep hearing me say high quality pair of boots. This might be the hunt you've saved years and years to come and do, and took all this vacation time, time away from your family. You want to have a high quality pair of boots, because if your wheels go bad on you, you're not going to have any fun. Make sure you use whatever waterproofing system the manufacturer suggests. Now, I use these wax-based systems that Kennetrack suggests. Make sure you treat those. We've done videos on this. You go on our YouTube channel and see all the videos of how you treat these boots with a wax product. Do it regularly and do it with liberal amounts. Don't skimp on this stuff. The other part is gaiters. And what they do is they go over your boot like this. So when you're in snow or wet grass or whatever, you have another moisture barrier right here. And some people say, well, that doesn't make that big of a difference. Well, have you ever walked through wet grass with your pant leg without a gaiter? What happens? The cuff of your pant gets really wet. If this is your sock inside your boot, what it does without a gaiter, that pant cuff is hitting this. And have you ever taken a paper towel and just taken the corner of it onto a little puddle of water and seen what happens? All of a sudden the water starts working its way up that paper towel. Some people call it cohesion, adhesion, whatever. The same thing happens with this sock in your pant cuff. You start getting moisture that is melted snow or just wet grass on your pant cuff. It starts touching your sock, and that starts wicking its way down into your boot. A pair of gaiters like this, a high quality gaiter, will do a lot to keep moisture from being introduced inside your boot. Anyhow, I hope you enjoyed this. If you go down to the links below, we have a promo code from Kennetrack where if you buy their boot, they'll give you a free gaiter when you use promo code Randy. Click on the links below and leave us questions. We get to spend a lot of time doing this. We maybe take quite a bit of it for granted, and maybe we've skipped over something, but leave your questions and comments down below, and hopefully you got something beneficial out of this video. Thanks for watching.